start by talking about posture. Posture is very important in meditation. And there's no absolute rules about this, but what we're wanting to focus on is the spine itself. And we're talking about the physical spine, but beneath that, we're talking about the spine of energy, the astral spine it's called. So the primary thing is we want the spine to be able to be upright and relaxed. So we don't want to be having sort of a military pose where we're sort of like holding this upright thing and upright pose. We want to be able to have a tall spine, nice straight spine with the natural curves in it, but be able to be relaxed. And so that can even be a practice at the beginning of your meditation is when you have the right, when you're sitting upright, just go through your spine and even through your whole body. We'll do some of this in our visualizations, in our practices, but try to visualize and feel around your spine and just try to be relaxing all those muscles. Try to relax everything that you don't need to keep yourself upright. So, and what we want to do is actually start with the pelvis just tilted a little bit forward. It gives us just a little bit pitch forward. It gives us a nice firm, a good foundation to build sort of the building blocks of the rest of the vertebrae of the spine up. So just a slight tip forward. And we can accomplish that with like a wedge cushion on a chair, or even just a pillow folded over, a blanket folded over on a chair, or the pillow or the blanket on the floor. We of course sell crescent cushions and zafus and meditation benches are a great way as well. But all of those, just tip your pelvis forward just a little bit so that you can have that natural posture without the strain. So oftentimes in our world, we tend to round over. We're sitting at the computer or whatever. We tend to get a little bit like this as we're sitting in front of the computer. So we want to be upright and relaxed. We want to make sure that the neck is not pitched forward like it can get in at the computer, but it's also stacked up tall. Typically, we'll have the hands on the thighs, sort of where the thighs meet the abdomen. Ideally, the palms are facing up in more in a receptive manner. So that's optimal as well. And then typically, we'll go in this again in the guided meditations, but we want the eyes to be lifted just as if you're looking at a distant mountain peak. So we're not forcing them. There's no strain involved, but we're going to lift the eyes again as if looking at a distant mountain peak, and then just close the eyes, but keep the eyes uplifted. Again, we don't want there to be strain involved in there. We want to be relaxed. We're going to be talking a lot about focus, but that focus isn't with tension. It's focused relaxation. It's relaxed focus. That's what it is. So that oftentimes we equate sort of concentration and focus and all these things with some sort of tension, but we're trying to have it with relaxation. Focus and tension don't have to go together. We can have relaxed focus. So that's the basics of posture. All of it is just centered on this idea of having a nice, tall, natural spine with relaxation. We want to be able to forget about the body. That's why we use the different props, you know, the meditation benches, the cushions, the chairs, whatever it is. There's no ideal posture that's going to make your meditations magically different, you know. There are certain mudras, certain postures that can aid your meditation, but if getting into those postures is causing pain, you're going to be focusing on your pain and not on your meditation practice. So we want the body to be upright and relaxed and as comfortable as it can so that we can forget about it. We want to be going inside and not thinking about our aching knees or whatever. So we do the best we can. Now sometimes our bodies have injuries or whatever, it's just, you know, life happens. And so we have to work with ourselves as we are, whether it's sitting in a chair. Some people even have to meditate lying down, and that's a little trickier because it's really easy to go to sleep rather than meditating, and those are very different things. But, so there's ways to work with that if you are having to meditate lying down. But ideally we want to be sitting upright because it's much easier to raise the energy, whereas when we're lying down, the energy is going out and down. So, and into subconsciousness, into sleep. So we want to be upright if at all possible. And there's many props available to help us do that. And so it's worth experimenting to find some that work for you. Okay,